I think you could utilize space a little bit more. There's kind of a consistent wall of sound. I'm wanting to hear your melody, but it's just, you're both strumming like kind of constantly.
There's not enough hooks for me. I didn't quite get anything I can take away from it. I just gotta say, I don't know what everyone is jumping up and down about. You got an amazing singer. You're an amazing singer. I can hear that, of course, but there's no time for her to sort of rise up like a genie out of a bottle, because it's like, and it's so formulaic when it's down. I just found it hard to hold the song.
My lovely, the bookends over here. I wouldn't try to play the acoustic guitar like an electric guitar. And if you're both going to be playing acoustic, don't play the same chords the whole time. Try to make it a little bit interesting. That was a little distracting.
Avery, if it meant you staying here and trying something out, maybe a solo act without the band and moving on to the finals, is that something you would ever try? How do you feel about it?
Here's the thing. These are my boys, like. I feel like when I got on stage that night, I gave it everything that I could. When we got back to the hotel, all of us were pretty defeated, I feel like. And we all sat together and like really tried to like figure out what was going on in everybody's mind. And we all kind of realized that, you know, there were a lot of places where we all could have been better, and my boy Walter here kind of had an epiphany, really.
I felt as if, you know, the other night, I definitely didn't do the best that I could have done as a musician. I know where I stand as a musician. I know I could have done better, and I know things didn't go the way we planned, but one thing I do have to say is, yes, I did realize that there are other things that are slightly more important to me, and I'm sure y'all have noticed that with this trip. I have been constantly worried about my family. I have a baby on the way at home, constantly checking up on my wife to make sure she's okay, all while compromising me, making sure I'm okay with this performance, with practice. You know, I learned my lesson. I figured out what I want to do as a person. And right now, what I want to do as a person is be there for my family, be there for my kids, my baby coming on the way. I don't know what to expect. I don't know how to do this, but all I know is that I need to do this as a person now. So for now, I feel as if I need to step away from Mirror Lake to better myself and to be a better musician. I love y'all too. I love y'all so much. I'm sorry. I didn't want to cry. I really wanted to stay strong, but the emotions are all there, and it's a really real moment for everybody, not just for me. It's a real moment for even anybody who's gonna see this. I have personally, as a person, have never been put in such a tough situation, but I'm grateful for everything. Every moment I've had with these people have been some of the best moments of my life. Every show, every opportunity I've received, greatest moments. And I couldn't go back and change anything.
Yeah. like spiders. Since we ended on the magic leader.
What an amazing couple weeks, coming in with no expectations to making it to the finals. Are you guys pretty happy with the results?
I think the bands that are there are the right bands. You know, it's gonna be a heavyweight fight.
With that being said, we're coming to an end with no cover.
Yes.
Is there anyone in this show that you can't get out of your head that's kind of stuck with you that didn't make it to the finals?
The Knife Fighter.
Yes. Yeah.
In a scary way, I think about him a lot.
Yeah.
Not in an aroused way, just in a way that he, I don't know, I feel like he made an imprint on my heart.
He did. Yeah.
Tony was the oddity, and yet there was something that you kind of trusted about him. You know, you kind of looked at him and you went, oh, I love this guy.
Yeah, he wasn't necessarily the person that I thought might win the whole thing. Obviously, that seemed a possible bit of a stretch, but I thought that he kind of upped the ante. And he spoke about things that felt very current. Basically, him and Slay Squad felt the most lyrically...
confrontational.
Yeah, just like something about their life and what's going on and the conscious.
What's crazy for me is the fall of Jenny March. I just remember her intonation was great and the songwriting was strong and the image was there, and then like we got a band.
I think she just kind of lost who she was,
I think she made one bad decision.
What really will translate, I feel, is like whatever is truly, truly authentic.
Yeah.
And that's why when she was at the piano and really just being herself and being vulnerable, like that is the thing that's gonna translate.
Whereas
at the end, when it was the full band, and she was, I felt like the way even she was performing, like it felt like she was like trying to do hard. That.
Yeah. Yes.
And she's like, she has it all, mm-hmm. but that's why when she did all that, I didn't feel like it translated.
You sort of diluted her.
Totally, yeah. Totally.
Yeah. 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 You know, Josie.
Oh, Josie, yeah. Yes.
Josie was a bit of a powerhouse. That's what she wears every day. Mm. You're living this character. And why?
So deep. Yeah. The question is why.
Yeah. You know, like, yeah. And I just trying to find
some. Yeah.
What is she?
Like, what happened
armor,
to you?
She's putting on. Like,
yeah.
It'd be so amazing to understand, like a voyeur. Like,
I couldn't
why,
get to that.
What's going on?
Well, I kept trying to get to the core. Well, what yeah. made you do this?
Right.
She wouldn't talk.
Well,
about
her energy yeah. did not embody.
No, it doesn't.
Kind of
like stand.
That guy did speak for her. Like, oh, Lzzy. Yeah. Put him in his place, 2021.
Oh, don't eat.
Nice shot.
He got farrowed.
I'm so glad Lzzy did that.
Well, I think that's part of, I think, the hindrance. I think they've right. been partners. He's writing her music, whatever it is, you know, because they do make some, like, really great music together.
He's very
I thought
good.
It was a very
really good.
Industrial, yeah. good. Really unique yeah. sounds. I thought it was really
good
great. But I think what lost it for me was the fact that, you know, and this was what I wasn't trying to be mean, but it was more of a warning, like, bro, you're getting in your own way. Mm-hmm. If it's going to be Josie's project, she has to speak for herself. Mm-hmm. You can't be taking the mic from her, you know.
Well,
and
doesn't it seem that they work together? Her. Doesn't it seem they must work together?
No,
but
they do.
No, but this is how the issue was. Like, even with the, but with the microphone thing, you know, like you brought up a great point, which is like, hey, like, you know, your vocal sounds really dry and it's like really not doing you any favors.
And then he was like, I hate reverb.
And then, and before I said, you know, it's not about you, I checked to see if he had a microphone, and he didn't. And that's why I said, it's not about you, but yeah. it was the taking away from
her. I think what we're not processing is, it's called Josie Pace, but it's clear he's doing all the production.
Yeah.
This is my assumption.
Of course, yeah. I mean, so, literally speaking for her.
And she's in an unhealthy dynamic that we can't support.
So
actually, we stepped it up was the Slaves of Humanity. I mean, when they played, they listened to everything we mm-hmm. said. They were one of the best bands that played.
They were great. And they're the youngest.
Yeah.
And they were so, it's so much admiration and respect for all the comments that you made to them.
This has got to be interesting, you know. Yeah. That my fear is that they're just, that if they're not interesting people, because that's the people we want to hear.
So yeah.
It's people that are interesting. So
the singer for Kodiak.
Yeah, well, the same thing with Kodiak, you know.
Really good at
yeah.
drummer.
Yeah.
They were really good. I think, like Gavin just said, they just need to find themselves a little bit more,
right.
you know, and be a little bit more comfortable.
But they brought it too.
They
the
did
second bring
time
it. They
yeah.
came on, they
yeah.
Yeah.
It.
Listened to everything we
they
said.
Did.
That lead singer was on the two things, straddling mm-hmm. it,
yeah.
looking
yeah.
us in the eye.
Yep.
I went, wow, what a marked difference that
yes.
is.
Yeah.
You know.
So going into the finals, is there someone you're leaning towards?
Both bands deserve to be here. It's going to be interesting to see what they bring to the table
yeah.
when it really counts.
Something
down
that's
to
different.
The wire. Like,
yeah.
Are you going to do something different? Are you going to just do more of the same thing? Are you going to elevate it in some way? So that's exciting.
It's also
going
to be interesting because originally, Nightspins were knocked out mm-hmm. by Native Howl. And they're going up against each other again. You guys brought back Nightspins.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's why it's going to be really tricky tonight, because you think both are very worthy.
It's about being as individual as possible. You know, we have such a great mm-hmm. cast of people that everyone's so individual here that there needs to be something to so stand out so that we all agree, you know, and it's really up to them.
Not to mention that both lead singers of each band are very emotionally invested in this,
exactly.
as we've seen with the Waterworks.
Yes.
So I have a feeling there's going to be a lot
they
of
want it.
As they should be.
As they should
yeah.
be.
Yeah.
Right.
And that's all we've wanted this entire time was
passion.
Like somebody
yeah.
to like want it and not just be here because
it's exposure.
It's exposure.
Yes,
or
yes.
not just be here because some producer said, oh, maybe you should.
All right, it's the finals. You guys ready to do this?
Woo!
Yes. I'm ready to do this.
Let's go. Yes.
Yeah. No cover on 3, 1, 2, 3. No cover!
So tell me about last night. I missed it. but you're still here, so something good happened.
Yes. Well, yes. What happened is you saved our asses.
Yeah, you did.
You did.
Due to your insight and advice, your idea about the judges needing to see
yes.
the compositional depth, the switching instruments, and you were 100% dead. Like, you couldn't have been more right. Because after the first round of judging, after our first song, the judges were literally verbatim saying what you yes. said they'd want. Like, we want to see more lyrical depth. We want to see a change of pace, something slower. Like, just bullet point for bullet point, what you said they'd say, they said. So. First up, thank you
yeah.
for saving our asses
last
night.
And then, so what are we pulling out of the hat tonight to make it different than last night.
Now we're taking your legit exact advice of doing Mercy.
Yeah.
And then Sons of Destruction, our newest Thrashgrass song.
It's still a song that we've been playing for years, and it's strong enough where I feel the composition will transcend any nerves that we have about it.
Well, I wish you guys a lot of luck. I know you're gonna kill it. I'm gonna be here supporting you guys, for sure. The set list sounds right, so I'm feeling it.
Thank you, man.
Thanks for everything, man.
Yeah, for sure.
Thank you.
Tonight in the finals, both bands, Native Howl and Night Spins, will be performing three songs each.
There's no deliberation from our judges. They watch the performance. They don't talk about it. They go straight to the napkins. Anything's possible. I'm super excited to see the outcome.
Can't wait. Back to perform one last time.
Let's welcome Native Howl. Let's go!
Father, I never forgive you for what you've done. Father, I never forgive you.
Thank you.
Carmen!
How you guys doing?
Good.
How you doing?
You excited to be on the final?
Oh, yeah.
Very much so. We brought a couple of brand new songs that we've been working on. You heard one of them in the interview we did. We got to incorporate your pedals into Wedding Gown, and it was awesome. It really added some.
Yeah, and you know, like it was a tough night just listening to the other bands. We weren't sure what was going to happen. And we're already like, you know what, this has been such a great ride. Mm-hmm. We were just so thankful to be playing tonight. And then suddenly at the end, just down the line, you know, night spins after the other. It was really cool.
You guys have had the most exciting of rides. So I'm missing. How do you feel about tonight, and what are you going to play?
Tonight, we're feeling excited. I mean, again, I think we're just coming in to have fun and just send this show off, you know? Kind of want to take it to church a little bit. I got a meaningful song I'm playing. It's kind of a tribute to a mentor who took his life when I was younger. And I'm going to do that one tonight, plus just a nice little slow ballad, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Brilliant. Yeah. What can I say? Fucking hell, good luck.
Thank you. I'll be here this evening.
Oh,
awesome.
So.
Yeah, good.
Thanks.
Really stoked.
Yeah. Excited to play.
They were brought back by our judges and have now made it to the finals.
Here for one last performance, this is Night Spins!
Please tell me what I'm feeling and who
Thank you.
Got one more song left for you tonight. This last song is called Sons of Destruction, and it's about
moonshiners during a hypothetical 2020 prohibition in the United States. A group of outlaw ragtag moonshiners came together to quench the proverbial thirst of the American people. They call themselves the Sons of Destruction. Not all these sins have been in vain. And that's why we choke down poison just to numb the pain. Plague I sent down swept the south like a hurricane. And if I'm down to drop down to hell, I pray God I'm first able to raise some cane.
Came around that I didn't.
Thank you. To the Native Owl from Detroit, Michigan, thank you so much. I'm trying to be
I ain't talking about Jesus. No, I'm not talking about Jesus. I ain't talking about Jesus. Talking about you, 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 you. I ain't talking about Jesus. I'm talking about you.
To the finals here, and no cover. It's been complete silence from the judges since the bands got off stage.
There's no deliberation tonight. It's just whatever they put down on that napkin, that's who wins, that's who loses. I don't envy you guys. Let's get to the napkins.
Good luck.
All right, the judges have made their decision. I'm so excited to find out who's taking it home.
It's time to welcome back in Native Howl and Night Spins. All right, it has been absolute silence from the judges since you guys got off stage. And I can't, the anticipation's killing me.
Let's bring in Matt Pinfield, who's holding the recording contract for the winner of the show.
Thank you, Matt.
Thank you, Matt.
We are not gonna have you guys wait any longer, and we're gonna try something a little bit different tonight. We're gonna have the judges reveal their napkins at the same time. All right, are we ready to do this? 3, 2, 1. It's Native!
It's been amazing.
We have the winner, Woo-hoo! Native Howl.
Great job, guys. That was so amazing.
You guys. How does it feel?
It's good.
I'm so happy. Hey, I'm gonna give this to you guys. This is for you. Congratulations. What an insane performance. But huge congratulations to Native Howl.
That was a heavyweight bout. If the record company doesn't sign both of these bands, they're insane. And if you guys toured together, that'd be the best tour on the road. That's good.
I gotta say that you both deserve to be here in the final. You're such an accomplished band. You know, you really are incredible. And it doesn't matter about sometimes whatever style of music you do, it has to be done well. And both of you guys have every area of the band, every member is valuable, integral, and congratulations to both of you.
I came into this show not expecting to be inspired, and both of you have affected me in a way that I'm not the same person, and we will never be the same because of you, so thank you. Thank you.
I mean, yeah, that was really tough. You guys are two of the most compelling, impactful, and charismatic bands I've seen. I've seen a lot of bands. And so, even though we had to choose one, you guys have an incredibly bright musical future, and it was a real pleasure to get to know your bands better, so, yeah.
I'm so, so happy for you, and I'm so happy for you guys, because both of your lives are going to change so much. Congratulations. Well deserved. Both of you.
I think it's safe to say that both of these artists made for an incredible first season of No Cover. Congratulations to both the winner and the runner-up. What an amazing season. Can't wait to come back for the next one. Congratulations to both of you. Native Howe, congratulations. Nice fans, congratulations.